I am Dr. Hemant Kalyan, head of the departments of orthopedics and sports medicine at Manipal Hospital, Bangalore. In these last few years, we have seen an increased participation in sports among India's youth, which is definitely an excellent thing for the country. Most of the sports injuries can be prevented. So how do you prevent sports injuries? First thing, especially for youngsters, do not neglect your pre-participation stretches and your warm-up. This is extremely important. You might feel it's boring, but you must do it because the coach will guide you how to do it. All the muscles, when they are stretched well, they perform better. Here at Manipal Hospital in our sports department, we have a comprehensive setup for treating all types of sports injuries of different varieties and different levels of complexities. Injuries would be broadly of two types. One is the acute injuries, which happen suddenly during the game, and second is the overuse injuries, which happen during the training process or during sports participation. We have a comprehensive setup for treating all types of sports injuries of different varieties and different levels of complexities. We have a team of arthroscopic surgeons, and we do arthroscopies of the knee most commonly. Second most common is the shoulder, and also of other joints like the ankle, the elbow and the wrist. And we can offer minimally invasive surgeries which help the sportsmen come back to sports much quicker. Many injuries can happen. Ankle sprains and fractures are one example. Knee ligament injuries are extremely common, of which the anterior cruciate ligament injury or the ACL injury is the most common. This may or may not be associated with injuries to the meniscus. The hip, being a more deep-seated and stable joint, tends to get injured less than the knee in football. And you also get upper limb injuries. Like in the goalkeepers, we often have fractures of the fingers, ligament injuries to the fingers, especially if the ball hits the tip of the finger. Wrist fractures and wrist injuries are also common. And then of course, there is the shoulder. Shoulder dislocations, rotator cuff tears less commonly than shoulder dislocations, fractures of the collarbone, these are all some of the acute injuries which happen. Chronic overuse injuries, which happen due to training. This happens usually due to either overtraining or training without proper warm-up and preparation or without proper supervised coaching. Don't keep quiet about it, because a small injury which may seem small to you may become an injury which can actually become worse. And many people's sports careers have been ruined because their sports injuries have not been tackled in time or in the right manner. Sports which have a high risk of injury are contact sports and very active sports like football. Football has gained in popularity a lot over the last few years, and youngsters as well as professionals can get injured. As this happens, we as a medical community have to cater to the needs of the sportspersons, which are very different from the needs of the general population. However, the flip side of it is that as the sports participation increases, so does the risk and incidence of sports injuries in this country. It's not enough to have a good surgical team. This has to be backed up by a good sports physiotherapy team. And I'm very happy to say that we have one of the best equipped departments of sports medicine in the state, in which we are able to do advanced rehabilitation techniques for almost all the varieties of sports injuries. So, I would say in my concluding message, Khelo India, All of us should get fit, but do it safely, do it well, and if you get injured, we are here to look after you. Take care.